Hello everyone, welcome to qfox.com. This is Arun Moturi. In this Selenium automation tutorial series, I am going to continue with the topic FireBug and FirePath alternatives. As part of this topic, already covered 12 parts in the previous videos. In the current video session, I am going to cover the 13th part, that is Ture Path Add-on in Chrome browser. How to install and use Ture Path Add-on in Chrome browser. So guys, let's get started. Ture Path Add-on in Chrome browser. So guys, as you can remember, there used to be two legendary add-ons known as FireBug and FirePath in Firefox browser. But those legendary add-ons, which used to be very good and help Selenium automation engineers in auto-generating the XPath expressions and CSS selectors at the same time validating them, okay, got deprecated, guys. Okay, got deprecated and discontinued. So we no longer can use them right now. Right. So to overcome that problem, okay, to replace them, there came a good number of, okay, good list of alternatives. Okay, there came a good list of alternatives to solve that problem, where Ture Path Add-on is one of them. Okay, out of all those alternatives which got off to replace this FireBug and FirePath, Ture Path Add-on is one of them. So Ture Path Add-on will not completely replace FireBug and FirePath functionalities, but it can do a part, guys. Okay, part of the functionalities that FireBug and FirePath can do, that is auto generating different types of XPath. Okay, auto generating XPath expressions can be done by Ture Path Add-on. Okay, whereas FireBug and FirePath used to auto generate XPath, CSS, validate XPath, validate CSS, like that. A lot of functionalities are there in FireBug and FirePath. But coming to Ture Path Add-on, partial functionalities can be done, that is auto generating XPath expressions. But guys, this Ture Path Add-on is, when compared to other alternatives we have in the list, Ture Path Add-on is kind of different. Why I mean to say this is, if you try to, okay, auto generate XPath expression for a selected UI element, it will not only generate a single XPath expression, but it will auto generate multiple types of XPath expressions, and it will allow you to choose from them. Okay, using different strategies, it will try to create different types of XPath expressions for your needs. And after looking those different types of auto-generated XPath expressions, you can select whatever you feel is good out of them. Okay. Whereas other alternatives, what they do, they only auto-generate a single XPath expression. But coming to Ture Path Add-on, it auto-generates multiple for your selection, guys. Okay. Later part, you can select which XPath expression is better for locating the selected UI element. Okay. Fine. So in this video session, I am going to practically demonstrate how to install Ture Path Add-on in Chrome browser. It's not only available in Chrome browser, guys. You can also get Ture Path Add-on in Firefox browser, which I will be explaining in the next video session. But in this current video session, I will explain how to install Ture Path Add-on in Chrome browser and how to auto-generate different types of XPath expressions for the same UI element, okay, using this Ture Path Add-on. So guys, let's switch to the practical mode now. Open Chrome browser like this. Search for Ture Path Chrome. Okay, Ture Path for Chrome, right? Just search for Ture Path Chrome. You will get this hyperlink saying Ture Path for Google Chrome. Chrome.google.com Ture Path. Okay, some text. Click on this link. It will take you to the Chrome Web Store page where Ture Path is listed. Okay, and as you can see on the right side, there is a button called Add to Chrome. Click on this button, guys. Add to Chrome button. Now click on this display pop-up, click on this add extension. When you click on this add extension, as you can see, okay, it's taking us to some website, okay, Ture Path website, the owner website and all those stuff, how to use it. All the tutorials are there for how to use. You don't have to go through them, guys, because I am directly covering them in the current video session. So then this, let me remove and add it again, guys. Okay, it's switching back very fast, so you cannot see what's happening. Add. So you see some pop-up is coming here, that is very fraction of time, right? Because it's saying that Ture Path has been added successfully to your Chrome. And you can see some Chrome icon is also there. That is, Ture Path icon is also added to the Chrome browser, right? Now things are very good, guys. So we have successfully installed Ture Path add-on in our Chrome browser. Now in the same browser, we will navigate to a sample application, say omaya.blogspot.com, where you can see good number of UI elements displayed on this page. Okay, for your practice purpose. Now guys, let's click on this Ture Path. Nothing will happen, guys. If you click on this Ture Path, what will happen? You will get the default options that any other add-on will get. Okay, This is not the way of using the true path, guys. So how to use true path? I am going to explain now. Okay, scroll down a bit. Let's say you want to auto-generate the XPath expressions for this button. Okay, so for that, what you have to do? You have to right click on this button, guys. Okay, and when you right click on this button, in the right click menu options, you'll get some additional option known as relative XPath option. Okay, you'll get some additional option known as relative XPath. And in that, you see multiple categories are there. Okay, using these different strategies, this this add-on, that is TruePath add-on, has auto-generated using the different strategies. For example, XPath IDs which are having ID HREF attributes, okay, like ID HREF SRC, it has created these two XPath expressions. Coming to this XPath with class name, title, and all those stuff, these are the different sets of examples. Each and every XPath expression that got auto-generated by this TruePath, okay, can be used for locating this button. Okay, multiple, for the same button, multiple relative XPath expressions got auto-generated for you. I feel out of all this, with my experience, I feel this is the best one. Okay, double slash button @ID is equal to BUT2 is the best one, I feel, out of all of them, because I feel ID is very strong one, and using ID in XPath will be more stronger. I feel like that. Okay. Now, if I click on this, okay, if I have selected, okay, out of all these auto-generated XPath expressions, I felt like this is the best one, right? So I want to copy this. How to copy this? Click on this option, guys. Okay, whatever you like, just click on that. When you select or click on that, true XPath home dialog will come. Okay, so window will come. In that, you see normal XPath. Whatever the XPath that you selected out of all the auto-generated ones will be coming here, and you'll also see a button called copy XPath. Copy this. Now the thing got copied, guys. Wherever you want to use, okay, in your Selenium automation code, you can paste and use in your Selenium automation code. That's how, guys, you have to use TruePath in Chrome browser for auto-generating and selecting the auto-generated XPath expressions. Okay, so that's it, guys. That's about the practical demonstration. Let's switch to the presentation mode now. So guys, I have practically demonstrated how to install TruePath add-on in Chrome browser, and also I have practically shown how to auto-generate different types of XPath expressions for the same UI element and copy them for your use in the Selenium automation scripts. Okay, so here ends this current video session, guys. In the next video session, I'll explain installing and using the same TruePath add-on but in Firefox browser. Okay, in this current video session, I explained how to use TruePath in Chrome browser, but in the next video session, I'm going to explain how to install and use TruePath in Firefox browser. So guys, that's it. See you in the next video session. Thank you. Bye.